Footsteps. Wait, mate. Here we go. Ah! Wrong button.
This footprint stands out from the normally spotless floor of the grand ballroom. Typically, the ballroom is cleaned twice daily, which means this must have been made by either Helen or her assailant or assailants.
Taste the dirt?
Communing with nature in your own distinct way, I see.
The dirt tastes earthy, with faint woody and fruity undertones. Amplifier, do the size of these footprints match anything you have on record?
Footprint is a tailor-made 8.75, suggesting that its owner was very particular about their shoe size. It is also the exact size that Halcyon Helen typically prefers. There are traces of dirt throughout the footprint.
Can you analyze the dirt?
The dirt carries traces of fertilizer, as well as the faint signs of crushed purple berries and grass. Grass, fertilizer, and purple berries can all be found in the purple berry orchards, located not far from the Grand Colonial.
So Helen must have been at the orchards before she died.
This deduction appears sound.
Good work, Inspector. I had a feeling we'd make some progress once we brought you onto the case. You'll need Administrator Ludovico to grant you access to the orchards. Contact him through the secure access terminal in your penthouse suite. Check in with the concierge. Your room should be ready by now. If it isn't, I may have to go shake someone by the collar.
Heh. You and me both. Anything else? Okay. Well, that's locked. Discrepancy amplifier.
How awful! I left my favorite jacket in there.
It's my favorite jacket now, lady.
Black hole.
Black hole what? Don't stop talking on my account.
Timeline discrepancy detected nearby.
Over here.
An industrial grade laxative has been added to the liquor in these bottles.
A laxative? So I don't have anything else to say, just a laxative there. How do I get in there? Alright, let's run up here, because we've been here already. Discrepancy amplifier replacements. Oh, this place wasn't open before. So this thing break every once in a while? Welcome, Dr. Winifred Goodnight. This is an automated reminder to make sure you clean the blood off your instruments. Patient logs. Available patient logs, okay. Alright, we have a Hartford Bosch and Nina Hahn. Okay, Hartford Bosch. Complaint. Back pains. Another day, another case that bores me to drink. The ill-fated Byzantine of the hour thought it prudent to gorge himself on enough purpleberry wine to incapacitate a primal. He then attempted to reach the lobby by stairs rather than elevator and fell down 6 flights. Automechanical servants broke his fall. He broke their servo mechanisms and will be billed accordingly. Fractures in left clavicle, right femur, parietal bone. B for Bosch, right? Maybe. Ribs. More injuries than brain cells. I recommend replacing purpleberry wine with Rizzo Spectrum Violet in order to appease Rizzo's company policy. Okay, Nina Hahn. Complaint. Extreme excitability. Finally, something a little different from the norm. Mr. Hahn came in earlier today, escorted by her sister. Apparently not long after arriving on Eridanos, the two of them went on a trip through the purpleberry orchards. Miss Han's sister visited the puzzle hedges, but quickly became lost. When she eventually made her way out, Miss Han was nowhere to be found. The sister claims that Miss Han returned to their hotel room several hours later, but has been unusual ever since. Her sister described the patient as formerly sullen, morose, phlegmatic, and given to melancholia. Her demeanor has transformed into an unpleasant degree of levity and shocking enthusiasm toward everything. I suggest vast quantities of cheap alcohol. Okay. Oops. Pardon me.
I'll keep quiet.
Good. Oh. Purple berry crunch. Nanospinch. All right. Not a whole hell of a lot in here. What are you doing? Trying to freak me out? It's working. Ah! So I think I should switch those buttons. But once I switch them, I'm going to start pressing the other button. Can we open that? Alright, we're supposed to get our room. Hello?
The Grand Colonial Front Desk warmly welcomes you, Inspector. It's a pleasure to see you again. How may I be of assistance to you, Inspector?
The Grand Colonial sure is interesting.
It certainly is a marvel of modern ingenuity, luxury, and ambition. Please, allow me to answer any curiosities you might have about our building and the amenities on offer.
What does the penthouse have to offer?
Twice the size of the next biggest room, and kitted out with any amenity you want, as well as many that you won't. Best to enjoy it while you can, Inspector. Typically, the only people who can afford the penthouse suite have enough bits to suffocate everyone on Terra 2. Also, please inform me if Woolridge gives you a hard time about getting a better room than his. Don't tell him I said this, but everyone on staff wants to strangle him.
Is there anything special about the upper levels?
Most certainly. All the important folks can be found in the utmost parts of the hotel. You can hardly walk 3 feet without bumping into a tossball great or a bored exec. Though maybe don't bump into them. Could be harmful to your health.
Yeah. And no one seems to talk much about the lower levels of the hotel.
Who would be interested in a staff-only area? Most folks never ask about the sewers beneath Arizo's plant, either.
You can't honestly tell me there's nothing of interest in an entire half of the hotel.
Of interest to your investigation? Well, I suppose there is that one door we're not supposed to open. But I'm sorry, Inspector. I'm not authorized to grant you access to any staff sections of the hotel. Mm. You'll have to find a way in on your own.
Well, you said that a little aggressively. Alright, well, that's enough about the hotel then.
If you're sure.
You've got some high-profile guests here, right? What can you tell me about them?
My apologies, Inspector, but that would be a severe violation of guest privacy.
What?
We here at the Grand Colonial firmly believe that... All right, my supervisor just walked out of earshot. Some folks just don't understand the importance of gossip.
There we go.
About whom? And what would you wish to know?
Did you know anything about... Did you notice anything about Halcyon Helen before she died?
You know, out of everyone here, I probably knew the least about Helen. I'm not much of an Aetherwave watcher myself. And Helen always had a crowd of admirers chasing her, you see? So she rarely stopped to chat. Friendly enough, surely, but always seemed untouchable. Emphasis on seemed.
Was she closer with some people than others?
Everyone wanted to be around Helen. She could usually be seen alongside Birdie or Woolrich, for obvious reasons.
Yeah, I did hear that Black Hole Birdie was staying here.
Ah, Birdie. Is he bigger than he is dumb, or dumber than he is big?
Oh my.
I have a bet with a friend. Not sure we'll ever get it to pay out. Birdie used to be Helen's beau, though he isn't anymore, and not just because she's dead. If I had a million bits, I'd spend everyone just to learn what caused their split.
Yeah, she lost her professionality real quick. Helen's co-star, Woolrich, did he have any reason to want her dead?
If looks could kill, he'd have put her in the ground 10 times over. Man's clearly jealous of her success compared to his.
Hmm.
See, I'd bet we're the only two people thinking about him in all of Eridanos. And I only am because you mentioned his name. If you leave woolly cow milk out, it turns to curds. Leave the curds out, they begin to get stale, then rot. Woolrich is on his way to the trash bin, and everyone knows it. Hmm. Either he's in denial, or he knew Helen would be checking out soon, judging by his increasing demands for a room upgrade.
Right, right, I read about that. We've got some kind of productivity guru here, right? What's her deal?
Her deal? Not making them. I'd laugh at my own comment, but everyone knows there's no bigger joke than the prophet of profitability herself.
Oh, really?
Didn't you hear Helen's interview? That woman is the definition of humbuggery.
Humbuggery.
Anyone who gives her the time of day is a right fool. I mean, Spencer Woolrich has taken several of her productivity seminars, and look where it got him. Don't waste your time.
Okay, that's enough gossip for now, I guess.
That's a shame, Inspector. What if I wanted to know a little about you?
I'd say too bad.
A woman of mystery, are you? Consider me intrigued.
She's intrigued. Okay, I wanted to see if my room was ready yet.
Ah, yes. We are most pleased to offer you our grandest of grand accommodations, Inspector. The penthouse suite on our topmost floor is now available for you. The last guest left her belongings behind when she vacated unexpectedly, so we needed a little time to tidy the suite up for you. Simply call the elevator in the lobby, and our highly skilled operator will deliver you to your private floor with efficiency and cheer.
Yeah, I just need to ride the elevator. I don't need any of that stuff. Alright, bye. So we got this key. What is our junk? Is it the junk? Items you have marked as junk, yeah. Penthouse key card. This key card grants the bearer access to the penthouse suite of the Grand Colonial Hotel. The last guest to check in never checked out. And we found this, right? Unknown compound. A small container filled with a viscous solution. Is that a faint sizzling coming from within, or just a trick of your imagination? I think we're supposed to add that to the pool for some reason. Alright, and this is from previous.
you like to visit?
P guest floor sounds good, but bring me to the penthouse suite. Let's get ourselves situated, I guess.
Next stop, the finest seat in the house.
And here we are. Oh, Ellie's here.
I'm gonna nick a few towels. They won't notice.
All our friends just came here. Oh.
Even the air in here feels too sweet. Almost sticky.
Hmm.
Sam's special inspector add-on includes a magnifying glass to sleuth out the germs and parasites that other cleaning products leave behind.
Good to know. I think we read that. Oh, there's more. It goes into a different room.
Everything's so soft and silky and expensive. Oh gosh, I hope I don't get any grease stains on the furniture.
Oh jeez. Stay away from the furniture then. What can I say? Pile of cigarettes. The number of cigarettes here indicate that the smoker's lifespan has been shortened by approximately 11.2 years. We can determine that, huh? What a mess. I thought they got this room ready for me.
Timeline discrepancy detected nearby.
Yeah, we'll get that. Oh.
Where did we go wrong? Oh, Lo, I'm so sorry. That didn't mean for... Helen! I love you. I love you so much.
Well, that's sad. We'll check the discrepancy last. Welcome, R. Bellamy, personal terminal. Messages. Please select an option. From Administrator Ludovico, subject grateful. Miss H. Helen, Halcyon Helen, thank you for choosing the Eridanos Atmospheric Complex as the site of your next publicity and marketing campaign. By endorsing the Spectrum Brown product, you are allying yourself with a revolution in the leisure beverage market. Indeed, in the culture of Halcyon itself, we're going to change the world together. Sincerely, Quinton Ludovico. From profitability, profit of, yeah, subject disappointed. To Ruth Bellamy. Yet, it says to Ruth Bellamy, yet Helen. Is that like her stage name, Helen? Helen, I don't understand why you and I must be enemies. Are we not both branches on the same tree of privilege? You command audiences with your masterly performances on the ether wave, and I command the attention of our corporate leaders. We're both cultural icons with a responsibility to set a good example. I'm disappointed to discover you've berated my seminars publicly and on official records. I take particular umbrage in your characterization of my most recent seminar, spearheading your project, How to Motivate Your Workforce Using Ancient Weaponry, as a, and I quote, nonsensical vanity project from a dyed-in-the-wool buffoon. These are fighting words. Expect to hear from my personal auditor soon. Sincerely, profitability, PO. Money can't buy happiness, and other lies we tell ourselves. A new seminar by the Prophet of Profitability, coming soon. From S. Kincannon, subject free advice. Miss Bellamy. You're a talented actor. I've enjoyed all your roles across the years. I'm especially fond of your performance in Terror on Monarch. Ludovico doesn't appreciate the serials. Maybe that's why he never knows when he's being played. He still thinks you're here to endorse Spectrum Brown. Your performance has him fooled. I have a feeling I know what you're up to. It's always a little disappointing when the audience is a few steps ahead of the plot. Best, Cedric. Oh, from Cedric. Guest advisories. Your safety is your responsibility. In light of recent unfortunate events regarding the passing of a beloved cultural icon, we at the Grand Colonial have doubled the number of armed guards for only a small security surcharge. Surcharge non-refundable. The Grand Colonial is not responsible for death or dismemberment that occurs off hotel grounds. Death or dismemberment. Oh, this is a bathroom. Wow. That's a tiny thing. Oh, earrings. Okay. Hoy.
The longer we stay here, the more I can feel my mind softening.
That's right, the guy's name is Felix. We were trying to remember his name before and I thought it was Fritz. No, Felix. Yes, Felix?
So this is what a clean room smells like.
Huh. Join us for the Profit of Profitability Seminar. This board is covered with a loose collection of photographs and papers. Examine the board more closely. A blank notebook lies open beside a stack of clean papers. It looks like someone intended to write something but never got started. Leaving a conversation with nothing. Workbench. Spatial acuity sensor apparatus. What is that? Early models included a speaker that would emit "look at that" in loud decibels. This feature has been disabled. the armor is nowhere near as good. Another bathroom. Oh no, this is the kitchen. Never mind. Dark matter bar. Cook it on that. Okie dokie. You've seen everything then. Now we have to use our thingy.
Timeline discrepancy detected nearby. The imprint left inside this suitcase matches the silhouette of Halcyon Helen's iconic handgun, the Needler. The weapon was recently removed.
Huh. Anything else? Oh, got some stuff here. Well, the other times it didn't make noise afterwards. Makes me think there's something else to find. Whoops. I got that terminal over there to look at. It's the only discrepancy that I can see. Damn it. I gotta... Aw, man, I pressed both the buttons. I'm glad I have a lot of those. Alright, let's use the contact administrator, Ludovico.
Inspector, I understand you've visited the scene of the crime.
I have.
Halcyon Helen was an important cultural icon. She will be sorely missed.
Right, right. You mean Ruth Bellamy. Halcyon Helen was just a character, which I just realized.
Halcyon Helen was more than a character. She was a brand. Her death will now be associated with Rizzo's Spectrum Brown. You understand why that worries me.
Just turn this into an ad. Rizzo's Spectrum Brown. It's heart-stoppingly good.
Stop. Please warn me before you provide me with unsolicited ideas. There are waivers you need to sign. Back to the matter at hand. Tell me about your investigation.
I've got a lead. I can't tell you why, but I need access to the orchards.
Your discretion is appreciated. I admit, I'm beginning to feel more confident in this arrangement. Here, I'm granting you access through the gates to the orchards. You're officially authorized to see this investigation through to the end. There is one caveat. Cedric's being rather intransigent about letting you into the spaceport. Possibly he's trying to hide something. Possibly he wants to annoy me. Possibly both.
So he locks his doors the moment an investigator arrives? That's not suspicious at all.
I agree with the sentiment behind your snide remark. Unfortunately, the Piraeus spaceport is Cedric's purview, not mine. You have a lead to chase. Law speed, Inspector.
Yeah. And Godspeed to you. What happens if I contact
Inspector?
Him again? Okay. What about these other floors? We have some other floors to go to.
Hi there, Inspector. It might be a little beyond my job description to ask, but at my heart, I'm still a bellhop. Was the suite to your liking?
It was fine. I don't feel too strongly about it either way.
That's completely fine, Inspector. Hopefully you'll warm up to it. Now, I'd love to bring you to a floor of your choosing.
I'd like to visit the VIP guest floor.
Oh, so sorry, but you're not actually authorized to visit that floor.
Hey.
What authorized floor can I bring you to?
Obviously, there's only one floor you can bring me to, then.
To the lobby we go!
Yeah. Very fitting elevator music. Alright, so we go through this way.
Coming or going. And when I can't get a hold of anyone in the orchards, I can't make sure of that, can I?
No, Miss Fergus. Sorry, I'll work on getting a hold of someone.
Great, you do that. I'll be waiting right here.
Hi.
Swear to the architect, Matthias, if you've lost your rifle's ionization coil again. Oh, wait, you ain't part of my crew. What do you want?
I'm not Matthias. Who's Matthias?
An idiot. I suspect he's avoiding me, actually, which is the first smart thing he's done all month. Sorry, but do you need something? Between the landing pad, lockdowns, gate closures, and constant questions from angry guests, I've got a lot on my plate. And if that don't beat all, one of my crew is AWOL.
Is it Matthias?
I wish. Matthias is about as useful as a Manta Queen in a Saltuna cannery. Wouldn't give a damn if he were lost. Frankly, he'd be doing me a favor.
Well, so you have a missing person. I'm actually an inspector. I could look into that for you.
If you're serious, I'd appreciate the help. He's been missing a few days, and we're low on staff as it is.
A few days? Why'd you wait till now to search for him?
It's not exactly uncommon for slug agents to go on the odd bender. They'll pick a place they think I don't know about and hunker down. Usually I don't bother with the discipline and paperwork. Gotta pick your battles. Thing is, they usually resurface within 24 hours, or at least yell for medical help. This guy, not a peep.
I'll look into it. What do I need to know?
The missing crew member's Evan O'Connell. He's one of about two slug agents I can trust with more complex tasks than stand here and look tough. Friendly type. Well-behaved, followed orders. Anyone else, I'd think they got drunk and fell asleep in a ditch somewhere, but O'Connell's not really the type. He was last stationed at the Wilderness Checkpoint. I'd search there first.
Alright, I'll get on that. I wanted to ask her something else.
Inspector, you find my missing man?
No, are you in charge of slug security?
Nah, I only manage operations around the hotel. Cedric does most of the maneuvering for Eridanos proper. I don't envy him. The only thing worse than babysitting a couple of hot-headed, overgrown children would be babysitting the entire lot of them.
If you hate managing people so much, why don't you ask for a transfer?
Situation's a little more complicated than you think. Suffice it to say, I'm not inclined to question Slug's place for me anytime soon.
Hiding something, huh?
I feel like our relationship would be more copacetic if you dropped this line of questioning.
It's been long as I got to beat the answers out of somebody. Do I look like a reasonable person, or do I look like someone who'll keep pestering you until you snap?
Oh, good. And here I was thinking that today was going along too smoothly. I might have used to work for Anticleo. Might have been security manager of a small pharmaceutical lab. After workplace spat number 175, I decided to defect. Defection isn't taken lightly. Can't go back, so now I'm slug for life.
Okay. Well, the pool guard told me to talk to you. He said you'd have some advice.
Oh, thank the law you're here about the pool! That crucial thing that isn't my job to fix, and that, as such, I don't care about! If you want advice, here it is. Don't talk to that imbecile ever again. Even by my crew's standards, he's duller than a telescoping staff. I put him on pool duty to keep him away from me, and now he's up my ass more than ever. How hard could it possibly be to guard a void damn pool?
Okay. Alright then. Well, excuse me. The way is now open for the Purpleberry Orchards. That'll be next episode. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time. And always, seek adventure.